chest plates thing. Where
the Xenosaw even have mysterious trait?
I'm pretty sure it has. I know it has at least one mysterious trait. Whether or not I marked it as having such.
Okay.
Oh right, it has its own little document.
Own document.
Has its own document. Yes.
Sounds and I keep special. Putting this stuff on.
I'd put special stuff on if I was given it.
Yes, you have continued to put the crystalline black armor on, which I have named something different that you do not know.
Oh, well, can you tell me what that is so I can mark it down on my character sheet?
You cannot be told that. It is telling.
This is some spooky shit.
It is that.
So spooky.
I wonder what it is, so what it means. All I know is that you should be wearing it always.
Stuff is gonna eat your captain's soul, and you're like, yeah, do it!
I can tell you that there are other people in the group who, if they were wearing it at certain times, would have discovered its mysteriousness.
Why are the... okay.
Things have happened to people that have not happened to the captain that,
okay.
Would have revealed elements of the armor.
I'm assuming
Dan.
That's
the has the captain ever been shot at?
Only by Eldar.
Oh yeah, she's shot
I actually got stabbed by Eldar, didn't I?
It's a shuriken gun.
Gun.
But yeah, you got shot with a gun stabbed that fired ish. Stabbing weapons.
Not pleasant.
Stabbed light. Half the calories, all the stabbing.
Was he wearing the power armor then? I think you were. Yeah, you were.
Yeah, because we were in that lousy environment.
Yes, she has been hit and damaged while wearing it.
Okay.
So we know it doesn't immediately invade the body cavity and take you over that way. Which, I have to tell you, I was seriously concerned about after I got shuriken.
I'm just curious as to what everyone else has done that you might not have yet in the armor.
Been covered in goo.
Well, that's a new select for you.
Get a foot blasted off.
I think at some point all of you have been covered in goo, although I don't know if the captain was wearing the armor at the time that you were.
Yeah, I think I've got blasted by orcs. Orc remains as well.
Yeah, I think all of you got covered in orc bits at some point when you did something to orcs that I can't remember.
Didn't they set off the
bandolier?
Oh, yes. That is the price you pay for using bolt weapons. A lot of things are going to get squishy really fast.
What do you mean, price? That was awesome. As I recall, I was behind the table at the time.
What about the fear check? Have you had a fear check in that armor?
I believe so. Wasn't I wearing it into the forest?
I cannot recall if you were or not. I think you might have been.
I think I was because I needed the carry capacity.
Yes, you were. And even if you weren't, you were wearing it when you had to make the fear test for the Tyranid Warrior.
Hmm.
I think I've made corruption checks in it, too.
In Silency, then?
Pardon?
Insanity, then?
Yes, in the forest.
Oh, yeah.
Corruption?
Same time as the insanity.
I go hand in hand.
Corruption and insanity sitting in a tree. Oh my god, what are they doing up there?
By contemplating that, make an insanity check. But so, the Zenith pulls up alongside the gutted remains of the Eldar ship.
So on a scale of 1 to 10, how wrecked is it?
Well, it hasn't blown up. It has that going for it.
I didn't hear a yet on that sentence, and that's a sentence that I like to not have a yet in it.
You're not sure where or even if this thing has a power generator. You don't know how to judge if it's going to explode or not.
Scan the hell out of that thing!
Yeah, it used to fly around to do stuff, so I assume it is some sort of power source.
At the very least, you know it was getting power from the solar sails, as well as you could tell.
So, yeah. Go with what Denov said and scan the hell out of that thing.
Somebody with scrutiny, do a thing!
Do any of us have scrutiny?
Nope.
I thought someone did.
I thought Romeo did.
Is Romeo here?
I do.
Aw, yeah!
Okay, yeah, that is a pretty thorough scan there. So, despite the fact that your sensors are crap compared to the Eldar's, still good sensors, mind you. They're just not fancy pants elf scanners. Space elf. Space elf scanners.
Yeah, well, maybe we'll jack those too.
Yeah, what do we have that isn't crap compared to the Eldar, other than maybe shields?
Well, that's not a very good metric. Your shields are better than all Eldar shields because Eldar don't have shields.
Yeah.
I think you have the same armor. But yeah, so you probed the ship pretty deep. Also a question for the ship to vent entirely.
A quick question. By the ship organization chart, do I have an XO?
That would be your first officer in theory.
Is someone currently occupying that position?
An undetermined NPC at the moment.
Okay, well, I'm going off headset for a minute, so I'm leaving Denov in control of the bridge.
I feel that's the right thing to do. Crazy.
Organization-wise, technically, her and Thaddeus are the highest ones up, I think.
Really?
Yeah.
I think the Master of Ordnance and the Warp Guide are the highest tiered officers besides First Officer, and,
I think, Geralt is the same, like, ranking as me.
Yeah, I was going to say, I'm surprised that Master of Arms is it over it. I know that the bosun ain't for nothing.
Well, the Master of Arms are the same type.
Master of Arms is below officer level. It's below, like, command level, like...
Oh, yeah, Master of Ordnance and Master of Arms are both ranked 3.
Mm-hmm. I thought Master of Arms was ranked 2, but I could be wrong.
No, it's rank 3. Rank 2 is only the first officer, the head of all the tech priests, and your accountant.
Well, at the moment, I'm largely concerned about warp phenomena in the area as well, so she has a specialty relevant to the operation.
Right. Well, as far as the scans pick up, you're not detecting any large, mysterious power surges. Well, you're having a hard time detecting any kind of power surging. But what little you're detecting, you're not seeing anything that would resemble, you know, a bomb building up. There's definitely stuff happening in there.
Hopefully death.
occasional flickers of movement that the scanners aren't quite precise enough to work out the identities of. And difficult to piece out from the interference of swirling debris and the occasional secondary blast that pops up.
As I recall, we sent over a team of murder servitors. Can we get a feed from any of them?
Ooh. Did we bring them back, though? Because I came back.
Yeah, I thought that was more of a hit and run thing.
I thought we were leaving some of them
we
there.
Left them.
Well, you'd have to pull up pretty close to get their signals. But it's something you can attempt.
Yeah, while we're doing that, have another team look at the star. I want to make sure there aren't any new and exciting stellar phenomena starting.
There have been several tech priests that have been observing the star since you entered the system and just kind of never stopped.
It's like, all hail the mighty glow star.
If they start hailing it, we definitely need to do something about that.
So if we're going to pull close to the ship, I'm assuming I need to roll a pilot?
Pilot would be a wise thing.
Apparently,
holy
I like
crap.
These.
Romeo is on point.
It's going to be like the Star Trek episode where they were caught in a time loop.
I'm currently drinking a midnight coffee, so...
Okay, so Romeo... slides right on in like a boss. The ship's nifty deflector shields that you spent a little extra on, just pushing aside all of the debris that's been cast up from your bombardment of the Eldar vessel.
Tokyo drift right up beside it.
Various searchlights from the side of your ship cut across it. Dead hulking ghost ship. Complete with tattered sails after your bombardment. All it needs is a crew of skeletons.
They're probably all running to the sun right now anyway.
Oh yeah, all the ghosts.
There really isn't anything resembling a proper docking port that you can think you could access. You could try. You know where some may be. But the ship has been pretty heavily damaged at this point.
Well, we can teleport now.
That's nifty.
Yeah, you are in teleport range. None of the weird interference thing has happened on when you've neared some of the shit on some of those planets.
We can also just straight up roll a cutter in there.
I'll be right back. I have to grab a plate of food. You all can discuss your travel plans.
I'm cool with teleporting. Worst case, if we find a thing we don't like, we can just go, oh shit, and get out.
Assuming there isn't interference then, we're probably going to want to go over in a couple of teams, some of us, to secure the bridge and hopefully their main computer system. Someone to make sure that it's not going to explode from engineering. And team loot acquisition. I expect a lot of volunteers for Team Loot Acquisition.
I'm up for Team Loot Acquisition.
See, how did I know?
Unfortunately, Romeo's got to go to the bridge. Because he's the only one I know that speaks Eldar.
And how thoughtful of you to volunteer for that duty before you were called upon.
He knows what he's about. He knows what's necessary.
I'm trying to figure out what's the least likely to have problems, because I'm still at -5 wounds.
You can just stay in medical if you want.
Just put up, have a astropath next to me the entire time, just giving me the 411, like watching TV. Or listening to a radio show. But then I can't help with any warp-related stuff, though. Hopefully there won't be any warp-related stuff. Or if there is warp-related stuff, tell me. Maybe then I'll consider going over.
There might be some warp stuff if you can find the high seas room.
Which probably is going to be on the bridge, or around the bridge. She seemed pretty high ranked.
Well, I assume that she owns the ship.
Oh yeah, fair enough.
Maybe we'll find her corpse in medical, looking like Two-Face.
I don't know, Elder have got some tricky shit. She might have, done some warp shit and teleported herself out. That is something that can happen.
It's entirely possible, but you may recall that I did dump some plasma fire in there before that hole closed.
Yeah, that room wasn't looking too nice. Or her.
Yeah, we also vented the bridge.
Okay, I'm back.
Yo.
Welcome back.
So, preparing to surge into the unknown of the Eldar craft.
Surgeon.
So, had you decided upon a means by which you were surging into the Eldar craft?
Apparently we're splitting the party.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Who's going where?
So far we know Romeo is definitely going to the bridge, mostly because he is the person who can reliably read everything. I kind of assume the captain will be coming to the bridge as well, just because of her tech expertise.
That is so.
Geralt volunteered to run around and loot the place.
Why don't we just do one thing at a time then? I mean, we're not in any rush. It's not going anywhere.
Deneth's just keeping an astropath with her in medical while she's at -5 health.
Well, I don't have anything explicitly to go by for this. I just feel like we're on the clock.
Hey. I mean, I don't think it would take that much longer if we took the time to stick together. I don't think... Plus, we sort of need all the rolls.
Especially if you can teleport to certain areas.
And also considering how we're a few days away from Metellus Prime anyway. I mean, taking 6 hours to raid this ship isn't going to change that much in the grand scheme of things. But also the things Romeo's most concerned about is A, getting files, and B, making sure they didn't transmit their location. Because more Eldar could show up. Like, it's cool, we can leave this thing as long as we can leave our own transmitter on it and take away any of theirs. And then we can just come back and raid it at our leisure if we are on a clock, or if we are on the suspicion of being on a clock. Because, I'm running under the assumption that, distress or homing beacons are things. That doesn't sound too crazy to me.
Well, I mean, it's likely that human ships still use them. No idea what the Eldar think of them. Alright, you've talked me into it. Let's start on the bridge.
At the very least, you know what humans use for distress beacons. Which, yes, it's astropods.
Hooray! But, like, yeah, we can't leave, so that means we can't leave, we probably just can't leave an astropath in here, right?
I'm saying one thing, if even if they did, how, like, imagine how long it would take for another ship to get here from wherever the fuck they went. Like, at
that's
least
actually,
a day.
That's actually a good call, yeah, because traveling the webway isn't free time either.
Yeah, it's still the warp. It's just different parts of the warp.
Yeah. Yeah, it's not free. Yeah, that's a really good point. I mean, Deneth can locate this thing anyway, because it's big enough. We know the general region of space, and it doesn't matter if it's cloaked. So, like, we can at least get, like, a decent shot at it, because Deneth can just scan this area of the void with her brains.
I think we should just go in.
Yeah, let's do it.
So, a flash of light and you're on the bridge of the Eldar craft?
Well, we should probably suit up first.
Yeah. Keep an eye on
you. No, I explicitly don't want my suit.
Power armor, let's go.
Yeah, likewise.
You explicitly don't want your suit?
No, I'm joking.
You explicitly want to test out the suffocation depressurization rules that totally exist?
Oh, really? How long is it until I die?
Not too long.
Shorter or faster than D&D?
D&D has rules for vacuum?
D&D has rules for suffocation, and that includes you, like, being thrown into a river, being thrown into alternate planes that don't have air.
Do you insta-die at any point on the D&D scale?
Yes.
Regardless of how many hit points you have at that point?
Yeah, it takes you... Actually, first thing it does is knock you down to -1 and you're unconscious, and then after, like, another 2 rounds, you die.
Right.
At least in 3.5 rules. I don't know if it does in 5th.
Right. Yeah, I am not sure. I mean, I haven't looked them up in Rogue Trader recently. I glanced over them a bit previously. But given how little health people have in this game, anything that ignores toughness and armor is going to take you down pretty fast.
Yeah, that's pretty brutal.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, you'd at least get like if you have like 10 constitution, you get like a minute out of not breathing in or holding your breath in 3.5.
Also, interesting 3.5 fact, a extremely high-level barbarian is totally capable of surviving re-entry, cratering on the ground, getting up and walking away.
That sounds awesome. I totally don't know how that would work, because that's like a lot of fall damage, but yeah.
I'm just picturing this big, muscly guy riding an axe down, and in the background you hear Aerosmith, "Don't wanna close my eyes."
Anywho, so yes, you all suit up, and a flash of warp light, and you are on the bridge of the Eldar ship.
Yes.
So your view rapidly changes from the... I have no clue what the interior of your teleportarium looks like.
I'm assuming it's got soil and plants and little lizards.
I'm assuming it is crazy big on the inside.
I kind of always thought of it as like a small elevated circular pad.
I'm assuming the pad itself is small, but the room is probably large.
It's a Foggate!
For all of the mysterious technology that nobody on the ship completely understands. I mean, to a point the tech priests understand it, but at the end of the day, they're just pushing a button. They don't really know how this thing works. And your bodies are torn asunder, thrown through the warp, and rematerialize after the hole from hell is punched back into real space on the other side on the bridge of the Eldar ship. A fine journey, all things considered.
Oh, how much crew do we have with us?
I assume just those.
Tech priests, astropath, red shirts,
mercury servitors. Yeah, would we ever not red shirt?
Better have an astropath.
The last time was on the Space Hulk. I believe it was just us.
That is totally a teleportarium, yes.
Oh, and Denev, of course, keep all of your eyes open for unusual warp phenomena building up while we're over there.
Yes, Lady Door Captain. Drink.
Okay, so the bridge of the Eldar ship, gravity seems rather low here, though it is present still. Random debris floating about just outside of the ship. You can see hard vacuum outside. There's all manner of strange little crystalline lights here and there, various consoles and platforms and chairs. Those that survived, of course, the bridge did take a pretty good hit. Thaddeus' gunner crews did a pretty good job at carving it up.
I think I'll breathe lies pretty bad.
And the occasional Eldar corpse is seen just outside of the blast holes, or, you know, scattered about the room.
Kick one for me!
Kick one of the corpses with the foot that Denev got shot off. Not her foot, obviously, I just don't specifically remember which side it was on.
I can see you carrying around just like it's everyone to beat me with. I would not approve that it's mine because I'd want it back, but...
You need to carry it in a plastic bag because it melted.
Hmm.
Yeah, we're not going to put that one back, but it's okay. I'll make you a new one.
I'm going to roll a quick perception check. Mostly to find loot off Eldar bodies.
Right.
I don't know why I keep rolling threes. I think there's something wrong with my actual... Can I roll this like two more times just to check?
Sure.
I don't know if I just like put in this command weird.
You're hacking, is that it?
No, okay. All right. It's not three again.
Okay, so you've always managed to roll three times in a row.
I managed to roll three times in a row.
That is impressive.
I'm going to roll 11 times in a row next. But, yeah, okay.
Then we hog in all the good rolls.
Well, there is some miscellaneous Eldar equipment around. You know, the basic sort of things bridge crew would have. I assume you're looking for the more interesting stuff, though.
The ones that go pew-pew, mostly.
Yes. Well, that is a damn good roll. And this is a universe where important people are usually the best at killing things.
Speaking of important people, I'm going to be looking around the corpses here for the, her name escapes me,
Farseer.
But she shot me. Farseer?
Her name was not said very often. It was said.
But yeah, I'm just awful at names.
Or like Air.
Well, her position was Her position was Farseer. That's close enough.
What's her face? The asshole.
Farseer is what all of her buddies called her. Al-Sharan. Al-Sharan was her name.
I know.
Al-Sharan who Al-Sharad me.
That was nice. Terrible. That was terrible, and you should feel terrible.
I liked it.
That is what we call Lady Lord Captain jokes, like dad jokes.
Yes, all of the crew obligingly go, ha ha ha, hee hee hee,
exactly.
Ho ho ho. Like Stanley.
Like Stanley?
Yes, Lord Stanley the Tool.
Oh.
Or like Stan Lee.
Totally different people.
Excelsior.
Yes, Romeo does indeed find a gun. I'm just looking for the right one, but he does find a more or less intact Eldar firearm.
That's cool.
Just fire shurikens.
How the fuck do you find ammo for that?
Do I find anything? Can I do an awareness check?
You can.
Okay.
Can I do an Auspex scanner aided awareness check to look for the Farseer?
Oh, wow.
That's a pretty good roll on Geralt as well. And yes, you can do an Auspex assisted roll.
We're about swimming the ship right now. Are we still in the hull? Or the main room thing?
Wah, wah.
You are still in the bridge, yes. Pawing over the remains of the bridge crew.
Did they have any, consoles?
They did. Some of which are not destroyed.
I'm gonna wave the tech priests over towards it. Assuming they aren't flocking around them like crows around a corpse, of course.
They are picking at this and that. To understand the alien mechanism is not something that is often taught to the Mechanicus. But they would not be explorators if they weren't a little more radical, and they wouldn't be on your crew if they weren't a little more radical than that. So yes, the red-robed and... Well, some are red-robed, some are in environment suits, depending on how mechanical they are. Are picking away at various consoles and pieces of tech they're finding around. Though they're not displaying much understanding of it at the moment.
Can I make a Xenos check to try and figure out what's important?
You can do that.
Not my day.
I'm going to join in that role for Xenos. That's over my end, sadly.
And Geralt is successfully able to locate... where is it? He pulls a... undetonated Eldar plasma grenade off the belt of one of the somewhat less shredded corpses.
Alright, what is that? What are stats on that?
Pull, pin, throw, figure it out.
Well, then you might have any grenades left.
I can get you the stats for that here. And Romeo does find a gun, and thus looking for an appropriate gun. Something that Romeo could actually find useful from the Eldar catalog.
Oh, great.
That's our equivalent of a sniper rifle.
Huh?
What's the Eldar equivalent of a sniper rifle?
Eldar fucking love sniper weapons. I mean, we're talking Eldar here, but I'm not sure if it's actually better than what you have.
Pretty much right now, anything better than his bolt pistol is appreciated.
And due to how exotic works, it could literally be any Eldar weapon, and the exotic town would cover it.
Yeah. I mean, heavy has its own problems, but I kind of think the Eldar don't have a lot of heavy stuff anyway.
No. They have some things. They have some things.
Meh. I'm more likely to find, like, fancier teleport equipment we can use and shit like that.
Oh, I really want to rip out their hologram projector, like, real bad.
Is that what makes them hard to see?
Yeah, it can make you outright invisible, too. And considering how good our ship is up close because of murder servitors and ship runs, it could be really, really good for the ship.
Alright, well, if we can figure out what part that is.
Aha, okay. I found the stats for the plasma grenade. I will put those in chat for you now.
Can I even use it?
Yeah, it doesn't require proficiency. Just toss it.
I think throwing it is its own proficiency. Throwing weapon proficiency is a thing, I think.
I think it is.
But, like, yeah, once you're good at throwing a grenade, you're good at throwing all grenades.
And, of course, you can try it untrained. It's still a grenade. It just might, you know, bounce a little bit off target.
So when you say a little bit, roughly how little are we talking?
I'm not sure. I haven't checked the scatter rules too extensively.
Pretty good.
Last one's pretty all right.
Make a roll for the tech priests with their prodding here. See if good things or horrible things happen. One of those. Okay, so the tech priests are poking around at one of the consoles. Not too significant, but there is some sort of surge, and the whole interface of the console just sort of shatters and sputters. Whole thing goes up.
Oh.
All the consoles, or just that one they're poking at?
Just that one in particular for the moment.
Unfortunate.
As long as we learn something, it's fine.
My Lord Captain, it appears that the remaining technology aboard this vessel is rather unstable after our bombardment. Assuming we are operating it correctly.
Are you sure you're operating it correctly? It is very alien.
We cannot be certain. We are not even quite certain what these consoles do, though we can surmise based on their location.
I'm going to roll, assume would be perception, but Romeo's going to start trying to dig through files. I assume there's just, like, stuff around. This is the bridge. I'm assuming they just have, like, papers and easy access to some stuff.
Well, you're not seeing any papers around, certainly.
Oh, okay.
Do they have, like, the equivalent of our data slates?
You're not sure if they have them in general. You're not seeing any here. It looks like there were some screens. Right. And I mean, the screens are still there, but they're dark.
So is all the power off then?
There looks to be what you think might be the equivalent of emergency lighting. There's various crystals embedded in the walls, floors, consoles, and such that are still luminescent.
Okay.
You don't know if it's on their own power or if it's because they're being fed power.
I'd say own power.
Well,
I think if we want to do anything computer-related, we're going to have to turn the power on.
Yeah. I was going to say we should probably start opening doors. But what's I wasn't that? Just going to open.
I'm keeping an eye out for anyone who might possibly look alive at any point. Even like the tiniest image of life.
Right.
Alright.
That's it.
Well, I guess let's go to a random door and open it. Romeo will open the door. He's got the best armor right now. And also is just least afraid of getting hurt.
Okay.
I'm going off headset for a minute, but this has my approval.
Okay. You begin moving towards the first door out of the main bridge, at least. And something surges at you the moment the door opens. Gut reaction. Figure at you.
I punch it.
Okay. The corpse of an Eldar warrior tumbles back onto the floor.
Ha, didn't have to waste my bullets.
Looks as if it was already dead and slumped against the door, trying to either run away from or towards the bridge at some point during your assault.
Well, that was startling. What's in the room that I just opened up? Is it just a hall?
Yeah, more importantly, there is a sort of central, some kind of communal chamber here, but with a number of what look like some kind of quarters off of it and spokes.
Okay. That's good. Are there any, like, signs up? Anywhere that can help give us some direction?
Utter language is a skill, right?
Yeah, it's a skill.
Okay, yeah. Roll your Eldar language skill.
Ooh, that is not good enough. I'm willing to fate point this one.
Okay.
Still not good enough. That sucks.
Okay, so there are a few signs here and there, but you're not able to really suss out what they're suggesting. I mean, you know, like, the literal translation of the signs, but it's meaningless to you without whatever the context is.
Oh, okay, got it. If I keep like around this area and keep trying to read signs, can I get another roll at it?
I'd say that's failed for this area. If you guys okay. are, you know, elsewhere, you can make another go at that.
Okay, fair enough.
You failed for this context.
Yeah. I am gonna start just trying to check random. I'm not sure if they have letters, if they have anything, but you said it was like an open quarters, right?
More or less, yeah. There's a large central chamber off of which there are several rooms. It looks as if they have doors that could close, but the doors were not closed at the time. They appeared more than comfortable leaving them open.
How big is their ship compared to ours?
I did not have any... I don't think I got an exact length. It's comparable.
Well, like, how many people would be on the vessel at one time?
You're not completely certain what kind of crew complements Eldar ships sport, but their ship is roughly the same size as yours.
Oh, okay, so it's pretty fucking big.
Yeah, I don't think we're going to find anything super great in just random crew quarters.
No.
Or anything relevant.
I was thinking that if it's small enough, then I guess we can just scout all of it, but it's pretty big, so it's kind of not a thing we can do.
Do roll perception, everybody.
I see nothing.
Perception is awareness count?
Yes, awareness would be the perception roll.
That's a pass.
If the presense goggles work, it's a pass. If not, no.
Yes, they do.
Okay, then they do. I pass.
Okay. So Romeo unspots this. He completely fails to notice it whilst he's going around squinting at signs through his void suit visor.
I'm thinking very hard about signs.
Whereas,
I'm sorry, I was thinking too hard about Batman.
They're clogging up the scenery and shaking my mind. I don't know what the lyric is.
Yes, Geralt and Thaddeus, on the other hand, hateful of the alien as they are, as all good Imperial citizens should be, they immediately spot something they recognize. The Farseer's spear in one of the quarters.
Really? Oh, well.
Ooh.
Obviously, he pointed out to everyone and moved into that room. Can I grab it?
You can.
Sorry, I missed the very beginning of this. Did we get EXP for last session?
You did. I'm giving you a little 100 on that one.
Okay.
That would be, what is that, 200 total?
Well, it depends if you've used it or not.
Yeah, I used my note.
You guys had 100 before. I don't know if you guys spent the 100 on anything, or if you even could.
Yeah, but I think I might have had some stuff saved up before then.
Right.
Yeah, I know I did, because I took barter.
Yeah.
I have a time on my memory, though.
Well, you all had 200 when you hit rank 2. That you then spent on stuff.
I might have.
Oh, no, this would make 300 total. 300 spare. Unless you spent that original 200. Or the second set of 200.
Alright, so last thing, we got 100. 100.
So does anything horrible happen when he touches the spear?
No. It's just a conventional spear as far as him touching it is concerned. Definitely an elegant Eldar weapon.
Yeah, we're keeping
for
that.
War pieces. If anything ever, like...
Well, we'll have Dan try it out. Have we found her quarters then?
Where
do you think it drifted in here?
It was inserted into a slot ceremoniously.
Okay, so it's probably her quarters, not just a medic bay.
Alright, so yeah, let's try and make an intensive search here. Maybe she kept a diary. It seems likely that a diary is going to be our best information source.
So perception checks all around?
Yes. For you all scrounging through the woman's personal effects.
Scratch. It's on chat.
I'm going to spend a fate point on that. Fate does not favor me.
I'm three under my check, so I have one success.
Look at this elegant elder wall I found.
It is elegant as shit.
Let's blow it up. Call us good for nothing. Call us nothing for nothing. Call us good for nothing but destroying shit. I'll show you. I'll blow up your wall.
And to think, every inch of this vessel is coursing with the souls of Eldar.
Nice and cringe.
Does this room happen to be coursing with the corpse of a Farseer?
You do not see the corpse of a Farseer, no. Okay, and was that a success on Geralt's part?
For the awareness?
Yes, I assume that was.
Yeah.
Okay, so it is...
That was his roll from last time.
Oh, that was the last time roll?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, no, yeah, I guess
36?
Yeah, that was the last spear.
Yeah, for
finding the spear.
Okay.
Geralt hasn't rolled since.
Even
okay,
better.
Yeah, so it is definitely Geralt who first finds... You're not completely certain what it is. It's some kind of small... It almost looks like some kind of remote. It has a button on it.
Do not press the button.
Knowledge Xenos.
All right, pick it up.
A shiny red button.
Yeah, pick it up.
I succeed on Knowledge Xenos. Two successes.
Oh, also, after I completely fail to find anything that's a diary-like, I'd like to look for and see if she has any hats.
Hats? No. You do find one of her Farseer helmets.
It's kind of like a hat. It can go on my trophy shelf.
It's like a metal hat.
Nothing like as good as my hat, of course.
No, of course not, Captain.
Which more or less is very much makes one look like a cone head. When wearing an Eldar helmet.
They will eat much mammal flesh.
Yeah, best as you two can tell, looking over this device that Geralt has dredged up, it is definitely some kind of thing with a button on it. It doesn't, has very little suggestion of what it would link to. Whatever, if it's a transmitter of some kind, it couldn't transmit very far. Unless Eldar technology is truly light years beyond yours.
Well.
And it doesn't resemble one of their grenades. Far too small for that. It fits nicely in the palm of the hand.
Sounds remarkably like a remote detonator. And say, if you had gotten some clueless schlub to bring a bomb where you wanted it, it's exactly the sort of thing you'd want to do when you were ready to set off that bomb. Paranoia keeps me warm around the stab hole.
Can we tell?
I think you might be a bit too paranoid.
Can we tell if the button was pressed recently? Or is that not a thing we can tell?
Not particularly.
Alright.
Well, I mean, actually, there is a little bit of wear and tear, actually. Geralt's most able to tell this when he picks it up. It looks like it has been fairly thoroughly used to him.
Hmm.
So you don't know. You don't know if it's been pressed recently, but you know it's been pressed a lot.
So it's probably not for bombs.
I convey this.
It's for a lot of different bombs.
I convey this knowledge to my team. I reckon this to your clicker has quite the wear and tear on it.
I guess the question we need to ask ourselves is, do we trust the tech priest not to push it?
That's a really good question, and I think for now we should put it in a nice, solid, opaque container and send it on to my workroom.
Okay, and it's fairly basic, but a shuriken catapult is what Romeo's gun is.
Okay, cool. Do you know what book it's in?
Core.
Okay.
Exotic weapon section.
Well, if we're going to find shurikens, this is the place.
Wow, not bad. Full laser burst does 10 rounds.
And it went through whatever the power suit actually is.
So 6 pen.
Okay, cool. Wow.
In my book it says 10. I guess my book just sucks.
Yeah, okay, so. I mean, you do also find a number of, you know, personal effects of the Farseer. Various clothes and trinkets. Things that you... sure, probably meant a lot to her, but you don't know the precise meaning of.
Nothing with writing, though?
Yeah, go ahead and answer that.
The occasional symbols. Some of them are distinctly symbols, not words. Some of them appear to be engraved from other people. Gifts of some kind.
Do we have anyone on board ship who can perform psychometry? Is that a thing in the Warhammer universe?
I can't recall if it is. I'm pretty sure it is, but no, you don't. If it is a thing, it's a specialized thing. And you don't have weird specialized people. If it's a forbidden lore or an unusual psychic technique, only you guys as players are going to get it.
Well, I guess carry on further in then.
Alright, back out into the bridge then. Seems to be some sort of officer's quarters, some sort of quarters for people immediately off the bridge is what you're in at the moment. After scrounging through the Farseer's belongings. As soon as you step on back onto the bridge, however, all of the various little crystals that seem to be functioning as emergency lighting, they glow a bit brighter. Surge quite bright, actually. Not quite enough to blind you all, but things do get up to a pretty decent light level. And it's only the crystals surrounding you guys.
Who is currently holding the remote we just found? Is it the captain?
Most likely.
Do you want to take a few steps forward?
Alright, I'll move along towards another crystal, I guess.
Okay, the radius of lit crystals does appear to be coming with you.
Interesting.
The power remote for the entire ship.
Okay, what if I move over towards one of the consoles the tech priests are operating on?
The emergency lighting type things do seem to continue to follow you, brightening and dimming as you leave the area. Doesn't seem to have a significant effect on the consoles, though. Just little embedded crystals lighting up, but no different data or anything that the tech priests are able to discern.
Okay, I'm going to hand the remote to someone else and tell them to take a few steps with it.
No one else does, I will.
I'm going to press the button.
Give it to a red shirt. I reckon we should be safe and give it to a red shirt.
I think we're overthinking things here. It's just a simple button.
Give it to Romeo, he'll press the button.
I was asking you to press the button, yeah.
Well, I was just trying to see if it was absolutely following that or if it was following me.
It's a good question. Well, good theory even.
That is a good question, as is it being given to Romeo and is he pressing the button?
If he says he's going to press the button, then no, I'm not giving it to him. I'd like to get the tech priest's opinion before we do that.
Then I'll hold it. I'm a good obedient boy.
Well, there we go then.
And I hold it and move away from the captain.
Okay. The brightening of the emergency lights does seem to follow you as you step away.
And it is indeed the remote.
Alright, so I'm going to explain the situation to the tech priests and ask for opinions on pushing the button.
We could attempt to dismantle the device, though it does not appear to have any manufacturing lines, no seams or screws.
So if you take it apart, you're probably not going to be able to put it back together.
It is unlikely, at least in the short term.
Well, gotta work with what we have on the spot. Push the button.
Okay. I will, then.
Okay.
My finger is on the button.
The lights burn that much brighter for a moment, and then the radius of light stops following Thaddeus and shoots off towards one of the doors. As if it were following some other unseen presence.
I think we should follow it, if we can.
Yeah, let's chase that light.
Yeah, it's chasing light. It is a Xenotech ship. What could possibly go wrong?
I do think we need to know, though. As you know, Eldar are quite prevalent with warp technology, as it were.
Well, we can't wait for right now. Those lights are moving.
If you see any obvious warp stuff, let me know, but that's the best I can do is just show up.
They're building
a foot. Let's get on following the light.
Yeah, okay.
Before it gets away.
Is it moving fast?
Decent pace.
Is it followable?
Yes. Doors are actually opening before it.
Is everyone else slow because of the low gravity?
No. Actually, low gravity increases your speed.
Oh, okay, cool. Rules.
Basically, everything high gravity does, low gravity does the opposite.
Okay, but there is still, gravity, though.
There is.
I can carry everything.
Yeah, it increases your carry capacity.
Alright, follow these lights. Follow the lights. Follow the yellow girl, the road. Follow yellow brick road.
Into a trap? No.
A trap with the Eldar? I mean, a trap is like, you know, it's like a trick.
No. What are you saying, Eric?
It's like a trap that you make the ground play on you.
Follow the pretty lights.
You do have to keep up a decent pace to follow this thing. But it's doable. Entirely doable pace. And eventually, after probably 20 minutes of trucking through a mixture of corridors exposed to hard vacuum, or ones that are completely black except for whatever lights you're using and the actual emergency lights that you're following.
I'm assuming that bullets are the most plentiful item I have on me, right?
Bullets in the sense of bolt shells?
Yeah, bolt shells.
You probably do have quite a few bolt shells, yes.
I'm going to leave some as a trail to get back, just in case.
Okay.
Good call.
A good reason to invest in a stick of chalk.
Truth.
One of those things that, for as big as your ship is, that's not necessarily something that is immediately on hand. Who has chalk in space?
People who explore wrecks.
Elementary school teachers.
I shudder to think what the elementary school teachers in the Imperium are like.
That would be horrific. Can I use tracking in reverse?
House. Oh, to find your way back?
Yeah.
Huh.
To find the path you left yourself? That's actually kind of ingenious.
I mean, you're following a path someone made. I mean, it's just in the other direction.
Yeah, you know it's
that makes sense.
Yeah, I buy that. Yeah, you can do that.
Cool. I mean, that's just a thing I want to remember.
Yeah, that is a legitimate clever use. I like clever uses.
Yeah, that's actually great.
Like some of the horrific uses of invisibility in Shadowrun.
Horrific?
I imagine there are a lot.
Yeah, especially because spells function through line of sight. So if you make a wall between you and the enemy invisible, then you have line of sight.
Wow.
Yo, that was one of the coolest things. And like 3.5 released a bunch of rules, including lasers. And if you have a laser pistol and you shoot someone who's invisible, they don't take damage.
What?
Which is really smart because the light just passes through you.
But so, you eventually find yourself in not a enormously cavernous chamber, but one decently sized. It looks like it was meant for rituals, meetings. You're not sure. There's It has a raised platform that looks like it was host to some kind of table. The table has since been tossed over.
Shall we take a table for our collection of tables?
Are there any plasma bolt shots in this room?
Plasma bolt shots?
Well, I mean, I don't know what plasma... I guess, like, plasma shots? I don't know what you call a bullet of plasma. I was thinking bolt like a lightning
sure
bolt.
Exists. It's what you would call a bullet of plasma. I'm not sure... Yeah, I'm not sure if that's technically a thing.
I guess basically what I'm trying to see is this the room that they went to? Because if there's a raised platform, this could be the way that they're using their teleporter. Or this could be their teleporter.
Oh, you're looking for a scorch mark?
Yeah, I'm looking for scorch marks. Because if we did shoot into a room, it could be this room.
Yes. No. This room doesn't show any immediate signs of fire. Well, not infantry-sized fire. The room seems like it's taken some battle damage, although mostly secondary. It's not actually open to space.
Okay.
Though, do roll awareness, everyone, as you enter the chamber.
Tech use?
Yay.
Tech use is... Auspex can work, and Prey Sense works as well.
Well, then I'm very much over.
Okay.
Oh, wow, that's six.
Okay, I'm gonna burn a fate. Not everybody else passed.
Yeah, that's kind of where I'm at too. I failed too. By a slight degree, but I failed.
6 degrees of success, if that matters.
Okay. What draws Thaddeus's attention first is the number of tech-augmented bodies on the floor. What draws the captain's attention is the numerous Auspex pings of murder servitor signals.
Oh, they're murder servitors.
Yes, there seem to be a number of murder servitors across the floor. Looks as if they've been blown to pieces, sliced, seared.
Any big holes?
In the murder servitors?
Yes.
Nothing that you're seeing, particularly.
Can we get a tech priest to try to recover any, like, video from it or any information from one of the servitors?
They have, like, video recording eyes.
They can certainly attempt to do so in the longer term. In the short term, however, you're pretty sure you know what caused their deaths.
Because it's in the room?
Yes, there is only one body left in the room. If the murder servitors did kill anyone else in here, their bodies were dragged away.
What's left?
You see what remains of the Farseer.
Ah, good.
Up on the raised portion of the chamber.
She killed a whole lot of them?
You're not sure if you have any more active here, but there's a good 5 of them that have been taken out.
Psykers, man. Psykers.
She was specifically quite special. Being one of very few.
If only she could have kept her bargains.
I have an important question to ask.
Her and then probably Warlock Entourage.
Does she still have her head?
She does.
We should really rectify that problem.
Volunteer.
Cult shot bolt pistol. Just blow it.
He's got a knife, don't you, Gerald?
I got like this big ass like fucking crude like.
Oh yes, you have a big ass knife, a Kraken knife.
Sounds fucking legit, man.
Call me paranoid, but I still think a clean bolt pistol, a bolt shot is the best way to do this.
I want
to
behead her. I'm gonna go do it.
Do it, man.
To your ass.
I pull my Kraken knife out. And I walk up to the body and I start chugging away at the neck.
Romeo goes to Overwatch. Psykers, man. Psykers.
Okay.
Does she have anything on her head, like a helmet?
She does have a helmet.
Oh, shit, she is wearing a helmet this time.
Yeah, she is wearing her helmet here.
Does it look any specialer, or just... Or would the helmets look vaguely similar?
It's pretty similar to the helmet that you guys recovered from recorders.
I was just curious if they had any, like, special headgear. Like, you know, warlocks, their helmets look different than just average troopers.
Oh, like, difference of Farseer headgear in general. A little bit. I have a picture here. But it takes a little bit of doing. She does have armor on, but it's not like she's resisting and you can pull things out of the way. So it takes some sawing and some jabbing, but you are able to, Okay, yeah. The big fucking ornate one here. I have suddenly spaced how to make images work, so here's a link.
Things work just fine for me. That is specialer, I guess.
The one you recovered from her quarters does not have the big thing cresting off the back.
I guess that's what makes it special.
The crest is the source of her power.
Maybe. I mean, like, Space Marine librarians, they have a special hood, which increases their power.
Yeah, maybe, actually. The psychic hood curves over the head just like that does.
You should keep that. That's special. Okay. I also want to look on her body for goodies.
Yeah, so I cut her head off successfully?
Yes, it takes some doing, but you do successfully rip that bitch's head right off.
Cool. Can I cut out her heart?
Yeah. She's...
Right. While he's engaging in all of his Hannibal Lecter-ishness, I'm going to search the room.
I'm going to search the room too, but as soon as Geralt goes to, like, cut off the breastplate, because I'm assuming he's not just going to chomp through armor, I'm like, oh, you want a cop a feel, huh? Dirty.
What the hell is that a roll for? Is that a snark roll?
No, that's a perception roll.
Okay.
Roll to snark!
Just give him a dirty look. Fucking hate aliens. Disgusting things. I'm gonna eat her heart.
And then he's gonna like peel off all the flesh and make a mask and...
Oh, maybe I should. Eldar Leatherface.
Puts lotion on skin or gets the hose again.
Have you heard of Chaos? I'd like you to meet my friend Chaos.
Is this basically how you feel the whole time you're on this ship?
I fucking hate aliens.
I do as well. Well, specifically Eldar.
I'm leaving this song on because it's good.
Well, Geralt is a proper citizen of the Imperium. He hates aliens like every human should.
They should. What's the one pat down for stuff? Or just generally search?
Okay, and
So I'm going to tie a cord, I guess, to her... does she have hair?
Yes.
Alright, and then I'm going to tie that onto my belt.
Now, by chance, did I manage to two-face her with my last bolt?
Let's see. It does not look it.
Oh, well.
Her helmet appears to be damaged, though.
I'm going to check and see if she had any, like, sidearms, like a pistol or anything.
She did have a shuriken pistol, yes. The very one that she shot the captain with.
Captain should get it. For poetic irony. Of course.
I can't use alien weapons, I don't think.
I'm pretty sure... Alien weapons are all exotic.
You can use it just at a -20.
Unless you dump experience on an exotic weapon proficiency.
Well, yeah, I don't have the proficiency, but I do have a nice place on a shelf for it next to the helmet.
And burn an effigy.
I bring the pistol to the captain.
Still has a little bit of the captain's blood backsplashed onto the barrel.
I give it a nice smirk.
Couldn't even keep her tools clean. Terrible decadence.
Does she have anything else on her?
Nothing significant. I mean, she does have bits and pieces of her armor.
One more kick for me!
Well, I'd kick her in the head, but it'd involve kicking Geralt now.
That's okay by me, Lady Lord Captain. That's okay by me.
Well, there is a gem there.
It's a soul. Actually, wait. There probably is in the helmet.
Wait, really?
Yes. Right in the middle of the helmet is the Farseer's soul gem.
Is she a magical girl?
We've got her soul?
We have her soul. We have collected her soul.
The Dark Eldar avoid getting ripped into Slaanesh's version of hell by never dying in the first place. The regular Eldar have these little gems that eat their souls instead whenever they die.
They basically, they trap themselves in a place that isn't hell, so they don't have to go to hell.
Purgatory for everybody.
I wonder if you could actually speak to her.
So, does Romeo find anything good from the perception check?
Nothing notable equipment-wise, however...
Yeah, looking more for, reading material.
The light is circling the room at this point. That is exactly what smashing an Eldar Soul Gem does.
Yay!
I don't think we should do that yet.
Did she see me creepy smirking at her? Because I'm totally making that face at her Soul Gem.
So when you smash, the Soul Gem, the soul dies is for forever.
No, it's. Basically, the Eldar gave birth to the Chaos God Slaanesh. Slaanesh now owns their souls. When they die, their souls go to Slaanesh.
So what's the soul gem for?
So their soul gem. Yeah, so their soul doesn't technically pass into the afterlife.
Oh. I'm going to be like, so I smashed that and it's like permanent suffering, pain, and torture for this woman.
Slaanesh, hang on to it for now. We can always smash it later.
Slaanesh being almost literally the god or goddess, somewhat androgynous, of, rape and cocaine.
Sounds like fun.
Wait, I got this one.
Who has the gem right now?
Whoever has the helmet.
So last we heard, you.
Oh, cool.
I'm just going to put the... Romeo's going to just chirp up for a second and go, I'm just going to put this out there. We already killed her. I think that's enough.
No, we need to kill her soul.
Well, hang on. Like I said, hang on to it for now. We might get to interrogate her soul.
All right, I put her soul in my belt pouch.
The personality of Slaanesh's herald totally mirrors Dr. Roxo.
Okay. What are the lights doing?
But you were beginning to ask a thing?
Oh, yeah. What are the lights doing?
Circling the room?
Yeah, circling the room more and more rapidly as you guys have been in here. And drawing closer to the center with each revolution.
You know, it's probably unlikely to be a self-destruct button if it's been pushed before. But is anyone getting kind of a self-destruct vibe from the lights?
No. Maybe a teleporting vibe. Not a self-destruct vibe.
I'm taking Overwatch.
How do you make this work again?
Pardon?
Images in the Roll20 chat.
Open bracket, space, close bracket.
I'm taking
bracket,
Overwatch as well.
Then parentheses with the thing inside.
Okay. Everyone's taking Overwatches?
Yep.
No, I'm not.
I am.
Okay, Thaddeus is not taking an Overwatch.
That will hide, though.
No space between the close bracket and the parentheses.
There we go.
It's cocaine! I literally found a Dr. Roxo at Dragon Con and it was amazing.
Yes, that is actually what Doom Rider looks like. He actually rides his motorcycle like that. Like, the tabletop model does that and everything.
Good.
He rides a motorcycle like Phelan rode that broom. A magical girl.
Anywho. So the light draws closer and closer to the center until it finally stops. Right at the right square in the center of the room. And then it goes out, and the entire room comes to a dim glow. Nothing blows up. Nothing ambushes you, as of yet. But beams of light do start to streak from various areas around the room. Would they be otherwise invisible if not for all the dust and debris kicked up by your fucking bombardment? And a hollow image is eventually projected. Of a far less dead, far less decapitated Farseer.
But the same one.
The same or different?
Yes, the same one.
That's better.
Oh, howdy, beautiful.
Can we find a holocron?
Is there a disturbance
maybe
in the force?
She anticipated her demise and left us a recording.
Well, there's
like a virtual diary.
There's no notable psychic signals that Deneb's getting. I mean, if they're there, they're too subtle to be felt this far away.
Okay, so what's the hologram doing? Just sitting there?
Well, it looks around at all of you as it's projected. Bit of a sneer on its face. Is your desecration of my people's vessel not done yet, human?
No, not yet.
I'm going to take her head and start making, like, humping motions into it.
Also, if you look,
I'm
gonna
say,
Garot.
I'm going to say, how's this for desecration? What did she say?
She sneers quite a bit more deeply at Geralt. Have your fun, human. This
I will.
This system and you within it are still doomed.
Care to tell us about the Doom now that Doom isn't any longer your concern? Oh, Doom is your concern. Soul Gem?
I pull out a Soul Gem from my pouch. I was like, ooh, pretty gem. Does this mean anything to you?
A perverse threat, human. The one which is hollow. If my people and I are to remain here and share doom with you, my fate would be the same whether that gem is destroyed or not.
Well, maybe if you'd been up front, we could have avoided the doom. So why don't you work with me? Really on the level now, and maybe we can fix this thing.
On the level?
Without duplicity.
She actually seems to smirk a little at that idea, looking away from you all.
I'm continuing to thrust in her face.
Which face?
The dead one.
Oh. Okay.
She specifically avoids looking at you. Although you're not certain if she actually has to use her real eyes or not.
Romeo's going to walk to the other side of where Geralt is to try to talk to the Farseer.
I'm going to shout over to Romeo. You want in on this action?
Nah, I'm good.
Geralt's doing gross things again, isn't he? Over the comm.
Yes, he is. I'm going to smirk at the hollow of the Farseer and say, you'll excuse me if I give my crew their head. They need to blow off some steam after an unfortunate incident that they were rather upset about.
Geralt chuckles heartily at that one.
I was more truthful with you than you believe.
You told me that this mess could be plausibly straightened out, so I'm not sure how that squares with doom and truth. Can you put everything in order for me?
Quite. As I said, the corruption in this system, the filth radiating from it, would be the doom of my craft world were it allowed to continue. And I assured you that were the Martellan devices to be deactivated, we would be able to end its corruption, and I would be able to save my people.
Are we the corruption? Oh, this is getting better by the minutes.
So what changed?
Nothing.
Rather, how does the corruption end? Is this a pleasant way, where it slowly fades away? Or is it a destructive and horrible way?
The corruption ends when this system is drawn into the warp.
Oh, what a surprise.
I care not for the demons and warp fires that radiate from this place. They will never reach Bieltan.
Well, I don't care about your homeworld being doomed. I don't give a fuck about that. I'd rather have these people here. They're human. And your homeworld can start off.
Hey, guys.
Her homeworld's already fine.
Quick theory. The thing we gave to the librarian is what's going to doom us all. Starting that one.
I believe I already mentioned this hypothesis, but...
Yeah, you did say that.
With the reservoirs turned off, the full power of the Martellan ghost engine is no longer being drawn away.
So you're going to warp the whole... So you're going to teleport the whole system to wherever the hell... Well, I guess it doesn't really matter, just away.
I will not be teleporting it anywhere.
I assume it will, like, collapse on itself.
That is up to the gods of chaos and their horrid servants. I care only that this system and you with it are gone.
Such loving kindness.
Understand that I do not ensure your deaths or the deaths of these people out of malice, Lord Captain.
Aw, oh, you're killing us all out of the kindness of your heart. How sweet!
Could have fooled me!
Me fucking your dead head out of malice either.
Understand that I would sacrifice 1,000 of your human worlds if it meant the salvation of mine. I would gouge the heart from your seated emperor if it meant but one of our gods would return to life. You are nothing to me, but you are not worth my hatred.
You know, same.
You headless jackass. If your people hadn't engaged in this sort of behavior in the first place, maybe you wouldn't have killed all your gods.
That is the burden that we must bear.
And so you go around making your burden heavier by making more enemies. Good fucking job.
I'm glad at least we didn't care too much either, especially since you fucked with our captain. That means we had to kill you all.
Our deaths are... I'm also assuming that you are close enough for Vox transmission, maybe slightly delayed. But Denim is more than capable of interjecting.
Yeah, she's listening to this all like a radio play.
Our deaths are unfortunate. Though not unexpected.
You can say that fucking again!
None of this had to happen like this.
No, it did. The only solution she had is to throw everything into the warp, and she wouldn't let us throw a bunch of humans into there in the first place. It was a rock and a hard spot, really.
Well, why are we... Well, does us being here really mean that much to the plan?
Well, I mean, we can't revert it now. They didn't know how to blow up Martellan engines. They needed our extra forces. And we already blew up one of the engines. So the best thing we can do is go to the other one and put the battery back in, hope it delays it, maybe try to save people or just our own skins.
Are you discussing that in front of her?
Yeah, Romeo doesn't give a shit about her at this point. Well, I mean, he's got, like, some kind of begrudging respect, because it is, like... I mean, he would fuck over a bunch of Eldar, too. So it's kind of mutual. So that's to be expected. As far as he's concerned, everybody else is being a sore winner. They already killed everybody. You've won. That's fine. If she wants to be smirky, that's cool. She's dead.
Technically not fully dead.
You're dead, I'm alive. That's all I care about.
She doesn't have a body. But she's
off the board, and we can send her to hell at any point we want.
What are you talking about? Her body's right there.
Yeah, I said she
right
like, her
there
body's
there.
Dead.
And over
she doesn't
there.
Have a body.
But if she was dead, she would not be talking to us and being stupid.
Yeah, I mean,
she's not being stupid. She's just being gloatful because she thinks she won something. We could always just warp the hell out of here, as far as I know.
But yeah, but then what we came to do is like not achieved at all.
Yeah, I know, but we don't die.
Oh, also, we drop an entire world of humans into the khaki.
We ain't gods.
We can be what we want to be.
I mean, I'm just saying, if we can't save people, we can't save people.
Well, yeah, but that's a defeatist attitude. We haven't even tried.
That's true.
I'm not necessarily willing to believe their assessment that we're all doomed. So, core of the ghost engine is in the forest, isn't it? I'm talking to the hologram.
I had never lied about that, Lord Captain.
What is it you know about the Martellans that we might not?
Enough to know that your Imperium was not unjustified in their extermination. Oh, they had no way of knowing that they were justified. Their reasons were impure.
Well, you just just announced that you were willing to send an entire world full of sentient people into the shit, so pardon me if I don't trust your judgment.
Did this corruption start before or after the Imperium arose in this system?
All right, Eldar, I want you to know before I crush your soul gem that from now on, once I get a big enough gun that can blow up planets, I will be going after Eldar planets first.
If he's actually threatening to crush the gem, Romeo's going to pull the shuriken catapult on him.
Oh, ironies piled on.
I'm gonna raise my eyebrow at Romeo.
Are the men doing stupid things again, sure you Lady Ord Captain?
Friend?
That's what I'm seeing.
I'm
definitely
man,
looking at a whole bunch of stupid right now.
Can
you kick them all?
Pressure soul gem, but I'm saying wait a little bit.
I never said I would do it right now.
Yeah, but you implied it.
We have all day to doom her to hell.
I'll put the gun down after I never said I would.
And the Farseer...
I never said I would do it right now. I said I was going to crush it, but maybe not at this moment.
The Farseer...
Yeah, okay, then that's fine.
The Farseer looks to Thaddeus. When did this corruption start?
Yes, indeed. Before or after the Imperium.
The corruption that is your concern, or the one that is mine?
They're different.
They're separate.
Question mark.
The corruption that's hers concern is still standing in this room. What up?
Yes, the corruption that concerns you began long before any of you were born. Long before the inception of your Imperium. The corruption that I am concerned about. The first spores of a plague that will spread from this world started on the day of her birth. She points it at the captain.
What I think I know where this is coming.
What?
Your actions here will set events in motion. One action to another... A chain of events stretching from here to the ends of the universe, and within that chain of events, the downfall of my people's craft world.
Good. I fucking hate you guys. The universe will be better off for it.
Can't say it's not your fault.
I mean, I don't have any intention of burning your craft world.
I do.
They didn't.
Your intentions are irrelevant. Your hand was never the one that would burn our world.
That is such a disappointment.
But your actions here set events in motion, cause...
And you're the one who set those actions in motion, so good job, Oedipus.
Not these actions, not my death. Had I done nothing, what you would do here would ensure our deaths, all of ours, not merely mine, not this ship. Your intent is meaningless. You begin a series of events now.
If only I had been given better information and counseling by people who knew about this instead of being used as a stalking horse. Why does everyone with prophecy just assume, you know, no, we can't possibly talk this out with the person we've got prophecies about. They'll turn against us.
We gotta shoot them.
Yeah, that always
fuck over everybody.
What's up with the shuriken pistol? Isn't gonna kill. You know,
So what do we do to stop it? Because if there's one thing you can trust in the entirety of the universe, it's everyone wants to live.
Well, so what? Let's think in the head. Like, what would have our plans been? What would our goal, our end goal, would be? To shut down the ghost engine, correct? That'd be our end goal, and get rid of our corruption that we dislike. That'd be our end goal.
I mean, I mean, if you want the end goal to be stop the corruption, that's already happening. They're just gonna.
Well, yeah, I'm just wondering what she hates that we would have done.
We don't know yet. That we are currently doing right this minute.
Wibbly wobbly timey wimey.
You think as small as I expect you to.
Oh, I don't know.
No, I know exactly. I think you're trying to warn us that the gods of chaos are going to come out because of the events of what happened here today.
Gods of chaos, no.
Why does it matter? Her homeworld's going to die. Let's just move on.
She's saying that we're all going to die, so as long as you want to keep living, it kind of matters.
Nope. Let me put
Do you have anything useful to say on the subject of shutting down the ghost engine?
I have no desire to. My last hope for my death to mean anything is ensuring yours.
Have you considered that this is the sort of thing that gives people complexes and lead them to want to do things like burn up entire species? Have you even thought, just for a minute, about being helpful?
Can I make a sneak check to retrieve the crystal out of my pocket?
Isn't that like sleight of hand or something?
That'd be sleight of hand.
Sleight of hand is a skill?
No, I'm going to burn a fate point on that one.
Well, okay. It might be advanced. So.
And he just like drops it on the floor.
Well, one way or
the other. Is advanced agility.
Just well, he failed it one way or the other.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so you basically just withdraw the gem.
I am losing, and I look at the construct with the gem in my hand, and I look at the hologram, I tell her that I am losing patience.
It doesn't matter, you don't have a bargaining chip in this, she's going to hell either way. That's what she just told us. Threats are literally empty. You're sparing her a few years at best, why does she care? She's already lived through thousands. The best thing you can do is ask if there's anything we can do to save her homeworld. Because if it comes to saving my own ass, you can definitely be sure that I'll do it.
If you want to help her, why don't you just go ahead and shoot the captain in the head?
I don't want to help her, I want to not die. And she told me I'm going to die.
She wants you to die, that's her salvation.
Right, she apparently thinks that us dying will save her world.
She has no salvation. She's fucked either way. She's dead already.
Well, not right now. No, she doesn't. If she succeeded, she would have been fine.
The only thing she wants is revenge, which, you know, is the reason why she's dead right now.
She still wants her salvation.
She doesn't have salvation. The best thing she has is a rock.
How much of this is discussed openly in front of her?
Oh, I'm saying all of this openly in front of her.
Okay.
Romeo is actually concerned with this prophecy business and actually thinks that I will save my own ass is a good way to convince people that he will do things in order to make sure he doesn't die.
The Farseer will look across to you all then, lay eyes on the captain. There is one solution, one which you would never accept.
Throw it on me.
She specifically looks at the captain when she says that you would never accept.
Well, if you don't think I'll accept it, you're no worse off for telling me than for not telling me.
Exterminate the population of the Martellan home.
That's not a bad decision. Most, if not all of them, are already corrupted.
The threat was never from you, Lord Captain. The threat was your altruism. You would do whatever you could to save these people, to end their suffering. In so doing, a man would be born, a man who should not have been born. He will beget a child who will beget a child, entire lineages that should have never existed. And they will set events into motion.
Should have never existed? Who are you to decide? What events are these in motion? All you're doing is speaking in riddles. What exactly did this prophecy say?
She's not speaking in riddles. They can see the future. We didn't know how far, but I guess they can see pretty far.
Yeah, that is too damn fucking elaborate for this situation.
Well, I mean, the only thing I can grasp from this is that the corruption is so
seriously, wait a couple, wait some goddamn generations and give a dude a fucking condom!
If you know this lineage, we wouldn't have to exterminate the whole planet, right? We just find one guy.
Were it so easy.
Is it embedded in the entire population? Like a virus?
In a way.
And what exactly is this horror? What is this thing that should not have happened generations yet to come? What happens?
I have no need to tell you of the specifics of my people's downfall.
I'm trying to help avoid your people's downfall. See, you notice that about me? Helpful? I am. I'm helpful. I'd like to avoid everyone's downfall here. And the maximum information available will help me to do that.
I am more than aware of your desire to help. Were there any means other, they would have been presented.
Couldn't you have just gone back after we were gone and exterminated the planet's population yourself?
I don't
know. They needed us to destroy the ghost engines. It's what we're good at.
I know, but like after, like, was there ghost? There were ghost engines on that planet.
Look, if you don't talk to me, then I'm going to intervene as minimally as possible. If you talk to me, maybe I can work out an intervention that helps everyone.
If we could just slaughter the planet's population, it's really not a big deal.
We don't have to slaughter the planet's population, we just have to leave. You're going to get dumped to the warp soon anyway.
Unfortunately, that is not an option.
What, leaving? Is leaving not an option? Or whatever else?
Not for you.
Do you mean from this ship?
This ship is no longer capable of fleeing. It was the only one that could.
So what you're saying is, if we want to survive, and humans tend to want to survive, we're going to have to stop this whole warp dump thing you've got planned. Like, did you think through this at all?
A plan that acts against someone must at some point take the assumption that they will not succeed in resisting it.
Was you prepared to die to do all of this?
Even with the extermination of every Eldar soul on this vessel, it is still a acceptable price to pay. I would prefer not to pay it. But that's
that definitely was on the list. Wow.
It didn't have to come to this. You could have laid all your cards on the table.
We had seen the results. They will know better.
Alright. Well, here's a question. if we did want to hightail it out and leave everybody else to get dumped into the warp, what would that entail?
Technology that you have obliterated.
Let's just chill in the warp.
Well, that's a damn shame.
Chill in the warp? I don't think that's the right expression to use. More like, get fucked in the warp.
Your primitive engines, if they attempt to leave this system, will be as a needle to a bubble.
Well, what I'm hearing here is break the Martellan tech, save yourselves. Anyone here not hearing that?
I don't want to hear it, but I'm hearing it.
I believe that's an option we have.
I accept there is a possibility of your success.
Can't blame us for trying.
I cannot.
I really wish you'd been upfront with us about this.
It would have accomplished little.
Is it not written, you never know till you try? And with that, I'm going to turn around and walk out of the room.
Hey, as you're walking out, I want to be like, what are the chances I can get this stuffed and mounted on my wall, my office?
If you can get the tech priests to move it, it's yours.
Cool.
And
your very own enigmatic oracle.
And awareness, everyone.
Holy
shit. I'm still there holding her spear.
That's under.
Under.
You're aware that she sticks her tongue out at you as you leave.
You're all aware of a vibration.
Bad vibration.
I'm gonna say beam me back to ship, Scotty.
Yeah, take it. Take everyone home.
Hold on here. Yes, you are being teleported back.
Okay, cool.
Well, in theory, you're being teleported back.
Use every techno jargon necessary to save these people!
In theory, so we could end up somewhere else.
Not so much that as the thing that's about to happen theoretically could interfere with teleporting.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's use before they warp stuff.
Before they teleport away, Romeo says a thing, but he says it in Eldar, so I guess nobody knows what it means. But I also can't not say, I also can't have people not hear it, so double-edged sword.
Yeah, but no one knows what it says, except for the Eldar woman.
Okay, yes.
What do you say in Eldar, sir?
Something that you're not going to understand, so you can't hear it.
I'm going off mic for a minute.
So how does teleporters work? Is this something that you do with consent? Like, do teleporters just happen? Like, oh, I'm being teleported right now.
In theory, it's something one does with consent. Our fine captain found an excellent picture of a teleportarium that I never would have put money on.
No, but how'd you get back?
Same basic thing.
You go through the warp. That's the problem.
But you end up back at the teleportarium's pad area there.
Yeah, but like, is a pad that we use to go to teleport both ways? Like,
more or less, yeah.
Like, the moment they start teleporting, Denim is just, like, in the middle, he'll be shaking an astropath. What happened next? What happens next?
How does that work? So, like, we go through the teleporter, we appear on the other side with a teleporter we use to go backwards with.
No, the teleporter just reaches out to you.
Oh, okay.
It's essentially a stable warp gate. Kind of.
Is it like, the astral plane in D&D? Like, you've got that sort of like silver chain around your neck, and you sort of walk around in the astral plane for a bit, and then you can get pulled back.
Not exactly. I don't think you're in the warp long enough to be cognizant of the fact you're in the warp.
It's kind of like Nightcrawler's bamfs.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure the silver cord comes out of your navel, too.
I'm pretty sure it's actually closer to the shadow plane, because the shadow plane is the place where distances are fucked up, and you can, like, take 2 steps to actually walk 2 miles. The astral plane is pretty much, like, 1-to-1.
Technically, in the warp, technically, I think distances are as 1-to-1 as anything can be in the warp, when physics don't really exist. It's just that because physics don't technically exist, there's no limit to acceleration.
Oh, cool. I thought it was more just that, like, distances aren't necessarily the same.
That too.
And time, I assume.
That too.
Well, space and time are the same thing, so whatever.
That's what the charts are for.
There are some elements of being a navigator where you're not just trying to arrive at the correct location, you're trying to arrive at the correct time.
I'm trying my best to be as good as that as possible.
One wrong slip, dawn of the universe.
Which is why I suck at dodging.
But okay.
That'd have to be a hell of a slip.
Talking the warp. Just because something is an extreme distance or time doesn't necessarily mean it's more or less difficult. But yeah, so, let's see here. Geralt!
Yep.
You might want to roll a dodge.
Okay, passed. What happens?
Captain as well. Have a dodge.
I'm going to spend a fate point.
That is a thing worth spending a fate point on.
Yay!
Aw, would have been more interesting if you failed.
Anybody else?
Let's see. By the look of it, Thaddeus. Romeo is the only one who does not get shot at.
How rude.
I kind of feel like he could shrug it off anyway.
Hero. Both fails.
Both fails?
Imagine it's 50.
Huh?
My agility is 50.
Mmm. And this is not the kind of thing anybody shrugs off.
Oh.
My body is ready.
So I'm assuming this is a thing that ignores armor.
How much, how many wounds does Thaddeus have?
9
wounds?
These are the wounds I have. I have all of them currently.
No, you have -1.
I'm at -1.
You can spend a fate point to reduce damage by 1d5 if you want to avoid going to critical.
Yeah, go for it.
It's 5 o'clock. Or 5 a.m. for me, rather. So, yeah, I'll do that. My last fate point. So what do I roll? You say 1d5?
Yeah, it's a d5.
Then I take 2 off that.
1 HP. Assuming you can have 0 HP. I think you can, right?
You can, yeah. Okay, yeah, in that case... Well, I mean, you do take the aforementioned damage. And just as you're about to be teleported, that shot slams into you and it teleports you.
Ow. What is it? A shot all?
That was a Wraithguard cannon.
Fucking knew it.
Why didn't it shoot at Romeo? That's what I want to know. Filthy race traitor.
I know, I didn't.
Hey man, I was barely part of the Imperium until a few years ago.
And you know what? I take the gem out and I crush it in my hand.
Is that something you could even crush, like a boiled sweet or something?
I don't think there's ever been a lot of information on how difficult or easy it is to crush an Eldar Soul Gem.
Unless it's like, you know, any gem, any, like, crystal. It's just like a semi-precious stone.
I feel like if it's a thing they're willing to put on their armor, it has to at least be somewhat hard, because if you shot it before they died, it kind of defeats the purpose.
Yeah.
If you landed hard on it, then, it just crushed my soul.
I mean, I'm assuming it's at least steel hardness, right? Which means you couldn't crush it with your hand, is what I mean.
Hmm. Okay, I put on the ground, I quick draw my last pistol, and I fucking... Eviscerator, destroy it.
Okay. I mean, I know they can be destroyed, so it's just a matter of potentially more effort than a bit of glass. But yeah, if you want to destroy that thing, it's getting destroyed.
Filthy race trader Romy over here, speaking in fucking Eldar tongues. Not getting shot at. Who knows what he said?
Paranoia on this ship is high.
Well, he knows what he said. Would you like to share?
Where are we?
You're back on board the ship. You don't see Thaddeus. Thaddeus, you are back on board the ship. You're just not sure where you are.
Okay.
Okay. We should really look for Thaddeus.
You're in some kind of access tube.
I'll crawl around.
Everybody the person okay? Running the... We're not sure where Thaddeus is.
If my vox still works, I'll be like, I'm in some sort of access passage.
And you got shut the fuck up.
And I got shut the fuck up. Those are the words I use as well.
Oh, fuck. How's the rest of the crew? Did they make it back?
Yes, they did. I don't think those are blast weapons. No, they are not blast weapons.
Okay, cool. That's good. No losses. That's pretty alright.
They are in Dawn of War, that's why I had to check.
Happy right, there's
so
been no
can
losses.
Can I start a search for Thaddeus?
Well, Thaddeus does... Basically, you're coordinating with Thaddeus on his Vox, trying to figure out where the fuck he is.
There would be a warp signature, wouldn't there? Considering we just came out of the warp.
Not enough of one to detect. It would be there for, like, the instant the teleport happened.
Okay. I don't know if it leaves, like, a trail or, like, you know, like, an after effect, really.
Like Jumper?
Yeah. Or like even portals in D&D when you open up when you do a teleport, like you can still detect it for like a few days.
Yeah, in this case, not enough for it to be helpful for tracking him down, but he is eventually located. It takes a little while because he was apparently in a portion of the access hatch system for the teleporters that the tech priest didn't know existed.
All right.
You have just made their day.
I guess
thanks for your assistance in helping
to
learn new things.
Well,
yes, let's get into professional Medicaid people.
I'm gonna take a nap.
Yeah, that they definitely encourage you to take a nap in the infirmary, both because you were shot with a mysterious warp weapon, and they seem to be very excited to study the effects of extended exposure. They don't say to what.
And it will just wave the moment he's in the infirmary. Glad you didn't die.
Yeah.
He can heal one, right? That's how, because he's in critical, he is like more than lightly injured.
So you are brought up to one wound by first aid.
So I'm at one now, or more than
yes,
one?
Yes, you're at one. Because you got to zero with the fate point thing, right?
I thought you said
no, he got to one.
Oh, he got to literally one?
Yeah, he got to, said, he went for, he
like
went
beforehand,
from
I was
one.
Minus one. So I got two damage decrease, so that makes me at one. So it's
okay,
two.
So you are you're at two.
I'm gonna as an aside to the captain, I'd be like, what if he seemed awfully willing to work with that Eldar? What if he said that he was willing to kill you and that's why he didn't get shot at?
I was willing to work with the Eldar. I wouldn't read too much into it.
Oh, yeah. But then he could have just said it, what he said. It's really suspicious that he didn't get shot at.
I'll consider it. Thank you for your input.
I was assuming you don't just say this in front of Romeo.
No, I said it as an aside.
Now that you guys are back on board the ship, you have a whole fucking city's worth of space that you could be occupying.
True. But we actually need to hightail it.
Yeah, let's get the ship moving.
Where to?
Martellus Prime.
Martellus Prime. Okay. The only thing we can do to not die is blow up the I guess, Ghost Engine Prime.
I assume the matter of the Herald is discussed, however.
True.
So, odds is that thing we gave him what was a time bomb and everyone down there is going to be really pissed at us?
Well, we don't know what's happened down there yet. We could have gone all, balls up, and now everyone's, fucking mental.
No, the bomb theory is actually a pretty good one, because he was staving off the corruption and maybe even the warp. If he's dead, maybe it's gonna... She wanted to accelerate the ghost engine to collapse the system, right? Maybe he was actively holding it that back.
Hmm. So what, you're saying we kill the Herald?
No, I'm saying we go kill the ghost engine and go to the city afterwards, because we might have actually killed the Herald and they won't be very happy with us if we did.
We can probably find out about the city from orbit. We know that it has a different corruption signature than the rest of the world.
That is very true.
So, yeah, definitely get the scanners on the planet right away and see if we can still see the city.
And we also know that, but we also do know that the device they gave actually did stave off the warp. Even if it is a bomb, it did actually stave off the warp. Or at least, the corruption. We know that actually happened.
And I'm assuming that people who are stuck in the infirmary are telepresencing into this meeting.
Yeah.
That's a thing.
We could just have it in the infirmary.
That's true, too.
Why does it matter?
I mean, it's a thing in real life. People have conference calls all the time with bosses who aren't there. But yes, you could just have a meeting in the infirmary.
As somebody who has to deal with video chat a lot, it's probably better to have it in the infirmary.
I mean, future video chat's probably a lot better.
We're talking the Imperium. Everything is monocolor CRT monitors with scan lines.
Yeah.
Think Aliens. Like the movie Aliens.
Was there any supposed, extended effects of being, in the warp or whatever? Anything remarkable that I need to note or no? As of yet?
Nothing so far.
Okay.
One of the higher-ranking officers the ordnance officers, one of Thaddeus's men, does bring up a point. Lords, lady?
Yes?
There's something we should consider.
Bing?
Yes?
We have no idea what that thing that we gave to the Herald might be doing.
I nod.
We'll be in weapons range much sooner than we will teleporter range.
Canton?
I'm sorry, was your suggestion that instead of assuming that the time bomb will blow up the Herald, that we do so?
Yes, ma'am.
I just want out of this accursed system.
Gotta go in before we can get out.
For all we know, the Herald is the only thing holding this entire system from falling into the warp. However, you make a good point. When we get into weapons range of the planet, start clearing the forest for me. I'm not walking through it again.
Now she's talking my language.
Do you believe we'll be able to approach this time?
No.
We don't have a choice this time.
I don't know. We can have full fault though.
It's either fall into the warp with this system, get trapped into the warp as we try to run, or turn off the ghost engine. Two of those involve us dying.
Well, uncertain death. Which, have no doubt, is worse than certain death.
No, the librarian dude might have some things to say. The Herald, he might have some things to say. If he's not already dead.
Were we smart enough to leave Vox transmitters with the Herald City? Please tell me we were smart enough to leave them Vox transmitters.
You didn't explicitly say so.
Oh, I feel like I've been sleepwalking through this whole mission.
But if anything, it is a first.
Let's see here. Okay, yes. You're the head of the tech priests. Your engine seer prime. Join this conversation. There is a possibility, Lord Captain.
A possibility?
If this Herald creature is still alive.
I know, we use him as a scapegoat and throw him into the fucking ghost engine.
I had not considered that. It is a possibility, but no. It has proven more than capable of shielding its city. We can never restore its glorious frame to its true might. We lack the expertise and the resources to bring such a magnificent piece of technology back to its former glory. But we can make it mobile again.
Oh, I see.
Drag it through the forest and use it to stave off the corruption.
Yeah, I'm sorry, don't you mean the Ashfield? I thought we've already settled on the forest.
Sorry, you're right, the Ashfield.
Well, when we get there, like right at the core, that's when we're going to need a warp, you know, defense the most. Just like from The Witcher 2, you know, the woman, she puts up the shield, and all the elves stop trying to shoot you. Just like that.
This is an excellent idea. Start preparing for it.
Understood, man.
Oh, a side note. I assume that we gave the spear to the tech priests to analyze.
Yes.
What's the spear?
The spear, the Farseer.
Oh, the spear. I thought you said spear.
No, spear.
I mean, I think you did have the tech priest analyze the spear, the one that you gave to the Herald, but as with most Eldar tech, the best they could come up with was a shrug.
I'm upset to part with it. That I will for science. I'm gonna kill some Eldar with it.
I mean, as far as we know, if we do a little bit of analyzing, maybe we'll, like, shoot lightning or some shit. Which is, that's why I'm saying to analyze it, because it might be not just a spear.
Well, if anything, it'd be like a force weapon, so it'd be activated by forcing, but like, you know, by using the force, but it acts as a melee weapon still.
Force weapons basically being power weapons, but better, but they require a psyker.
Yeah.
Yeah, don't they do some damage that ignores armor?
I think so. But we cannot guarantee that this Herald could actually have power over its own movements if we wanted it to in the first place.
I'll put him on like a cart and just wheel him there.
That is essentially our thoughts, my lord.
As good as any. Can we give it a mounted guns?
When you say cart, I don't think we can necessarily expect ramps everywhere we go.
No, suitable to all-terrain treads, my lord captain.
Excellent.
Like a tank.
I'm going off mic for a second.
How long will it take to get into the city, put him on treads, and get him out?
Assuming we are capable of targeting the teleportarium precisely enough, we will be able to considerably cut down our time.
Teleportarium sounds like an excellent idea. I'm expecting the city won't be too pleased with us for trying to mess with them.
You know what they say, you only YOLO once.
You only YOLO once. Words to live by.
There is the possibility that the population will be doomed. Of the Herald City, that is.
What, really? I thought it was only extended exposure to, you know, the corruption is what fucks people over.
Yes.
Is the short term really that big a deal?
It is possible, if only because the Herald's population has not had continued exposure.
Well, we've had some exposure, haven't we? We've been outside of the... We went into the woods. I assume that wasn't protected by the Herald.
Quite true.
I don't know how long we was out there for, but if the timescales would be roughly similar, then...
Well, let's put it this way. Are they any more doomed if we teleport the Herald than if we just let the planet fall?
Of course not.
So really, by those calculations, they're getting a bargain.
Certainly we will benefit from its protection far more than they would.
Well, they're yet to join the Imperium, so they get limited protection under it.
If we can fix the corruption in the system, then they won't need the protection anymore.
Sure enough, I mean, I've seen worse off people.
My vengeance is shall prepare the frame.
Does it have guns on it?
They would need to be liberated.
Liberated from what?
Some of our fighter craft, my lord.
Put a gun on it.
We'll delay the preparing of the craft at all.
How many days travel is it to the Martellus Prime?
Can't remember the exact. It's several.
Oh yeah, I suppose like it changes per route.
Well, it changes per warp route. This is a regular space route.
Oh, okay.
Well, we're unlikely to need all of the guns on all of the fighters right now. Don't give the Herald control over the guns until we talk to it.
I'm not certain we could if we desired to, my lord captain.
That's fine then.
It will essentially be a decorative ornament.
He may be somewhat hard of understanding about being teleported.
Grab the Herald, we'll make him a hood ornament. I love this idea.
I don't even know if we know.
This is totally a, this is totally like a Firefly blooper.
Desperate times call for absurd measures.
We do have the Fosse's hat thing. I don't know if that'd help or not.
Right, so someone should be watching the team who is going to start trying to use the auger array to map everything they can about the forest and everything underneath it.
I'm going to do that.
There we go then. I am going to go to my workroom and start trying to fix Denev up afoot.
Yay!
Can I, like, preserve the head so it's, like, a permanent... can I shrink it? Can I shrink the head to have a shrunken head, like, belt buckle? Or, like, belt, like, trophy thing?
Witness!
In theory, you can. I'm just not sure if anyone on the ship knows how to do so.
I just...
See, I'm just picturing you, like, hanging...
How do voodoo people do it? It's vinegar, right?
Also careful removal of the skull, I believe.
Do you know who might know? The people on the planet. Like, legitimately. They're kind of primitive.
Yeah. If anyone would know how to shrink a head, it's probably the
tribes outside of the city?
Yeah, the crazy mutant tribes.
I'm gonna shrink the head.
Hi, you might remember us from the orbital bombardment you experienced recently. Listen, can you shrink this head for us?
I didn't think they'd know specifically us. Maybe they would. Maybe you.
And that's less, hey, you might remember us from the orbital bombardment, and hey, remember us? We're the ones who called down the wrath of God on you.
God wants a shrunken head.
Frankly, with them, that's a pretty decent opening argument at this point. But, okay. I apologize for short session.
No,
that's
good.
Fine. No, that was
had a good time.
Had a good session.
Enjoyed feeling righteously pissed about the obstinate Farseer.
That's the Eldar. That's her thing.
Enjoyed face-humping her severed head.
Oh yeah, I was gonna say, I'm totally picturing, like, Geralt just hanging it face inward from the front of his belt buckle so that it bangs against his crotch with every step.
Yeah, remind me with every single every single step how I killed this Eldar bitch.
How you sent a bunch of murder servitors to do your dirty work for you?
I injured her pretty badly before that.
Do we have, like, a Counselor Troy on the ship? Because I think Geralt needs to talk to her.
And
can I ask a GM privilege question?
I went with the murder servitors.
Can I ask, like, a serious GM question? Yeah, I don't think we got close to killing her, right?
No. You guys did get a few shots off on her. You did injure her, but... Yeah, she fairly legitimately fucked up those murder servitors.
Yeah, I thought we'd even get her down half HP.
No. You guys may recall from your own fight with murder servitors how murdery murder servitors are.
Yeah, and she took 5 of them.
Well, I assume she has warp shit.
Yeah, she... Psyker powers. Crazy
bitch. And Wraithguard.
Wraithguard too.
What's Wraithguard?
That's where those shots came from.
Oh, like, okay.
They're like giant terminators. Like, not giant terminators, but they're like...
They're hulking size class, so they're about the size of space marines. And they fire cannons that ignore armor and toughness with every shot and teleport you with every shot if they don't straight up blink you out of existence.
They teleport
you? Yo.
Yeah, that's what happened when you got shot, but you were also being teleported while being teleported, so you ended up inside an access tube.
Dear Doc, I heard you like teleporting.
Yo, that's actually nuts.
Yeah, so a few of those started firing on you. That is, basically the Eldar equivalent of a combat servitor. Just an Eldar soul downloaded into a robot body. With a big-ass warp gun.
I want that gun, though.
I think getting that gun is about as likely as getting a Tyranid gun.
Damn.
How cool would that be, though?
And assuming the entire system doesn't go in the toilet, I think we could just come back to the ship and just start flooding it with murder servitors.
I did literally everything.
Am I rolling for anything while I'm watching this map? Being mapped out?
I don't think you need to.
Okay.
I mean, you could do the check yourself, but I assume you don't have scrutiny. The skill.
I'm pretty sure the only people who would have relevant roles at this point would be either me or Denev.
And yes, those are Wraithguard, as Denev has posted.
Well, Thaddeus.
Yeah.
Fail posted.
Just needed the space everything. Between the brackets.
Oh, I didn't see that. Okay. Almost perfect then. Even scarier, we could have a Wraith Lord, which is bigger. And another sword.
More or less the same thing, just, big. They can just kind of kick you.
Yeah.
And then the Eldar just keep making them bigger and bigger until you get Titan-sized ones.
Really?
Yeah, so you could have those things, but, like, the size of a skyscraper.
Jesus.
Yay, Titans!
I know the Imperium have Titans or Space Marines.
The Space Marines.
That stupid Titan suit thing.
I'm gonna head off now, guys.
Alright, see you later, man. Okay.
Have a good night, man.
Night.
Yeah, where is the completely ridiculous Titan? The Emperor class Titan. There it is.
I think I'm gonna get going too. I gotta work in the morning.
Alright. See you later.
It'd be cool to know if we get another 100 EXP, because then I'll spend it to be able to actually use the shuriken catapult.
Right. Yeah, I will overview and determine.
Okay, cool. Thanks. Night.
Seems XP is quite difficult to gain.
There's only like 8 levels in the whole game.
True.
In Skype, Emperor class Titan literally has a cathedral on its back.
Is that real?
That is real.
How big is that?
Allow me to show you an actual picture of a game of a Warhammer game where someone's using an Emperor class Titan. Also in Skype.
Oh, okay, okay, fine. Does it really need the chainsaw arm? Or the circular saw arm? Is that necessary?
That is totally a legal-to-field model.
Is that a chaos one?
I don't know. Yes.
It looks chaosy.
Yes, the 8-pointed Star of Chaos is on there. Yeah, they don't make those standard. You just have to build them yourself from scratch.
Okay. Do they have stats for that thing? Is that thing killable?
Yes and yes.
The shells in it are massive. If that, like... That's like what a ship would use.
Yes, they in fact have void shields.
Do conventional weapons harm those?
No. No, they don't.
What kind of weaponry does? Orbital bombardment?
Other super heavies. Bane blades, other titans.
Really, titans? Like, would that even come up to its knee?
It is a titan.
Sorry, I meant a bane blade.
Bane blades are pretty fucking big. I mean, not that big, but big enough to, you know, be able to harm it, maybe.
Or how big is it compared to the tanks? Like, you know, you see the tanks on the floor that are, like, barely come onto its feet.
Baneblades are pretty big. I mean, bigger than any of those tanks.
Yeah, but not so much it would come onto its knee.
Yeah, I couldn't tell you exactly how big. Definitely not up to its knee. But yeah, that is a, quote, model that would literally come up to a human being's waist. Not taller.
Okay. I have an amazing idea. Why don't they just pull out, like, the Emperor's throne, put it in one of those, and just have him everywhere?
Nobody wants to touch that fucking thing. Nobody knows how that thing works.
People can't even go in there, can they?
Oh no, plenty of people go in there.
Really? Well, I thought it was just like slaughter demons, like that were coming in through a warp portal.
That's theoretically the room behind that. Every single astropath has personally laid eyes on the Emperor.
Really?
Yeah, they go through a thing called soul bonding. That's how they can be an astropath, where they literally have a portion of the Emperor's soul bonded to theirs.
Wow.
That's cool.
So the only two types of warp dudes you can be is a navigator and an astropath?
Yes. You can be other types of psychers in the other Warhammer games, but they're
less... Well, that's like a librarian. Or well, unless you mean other types.
Other types of regular human psychers, like sanctioned psychers shit in Only War and Dark Heresy. But
so like Imperial Armor, like soldier class psychers.
Yeah, they are
the guys like follow the captains around.
Yeah, they're less stable than Astropaths. Everything you play
even less stable.
Everything you play as in Rogue Trader is exceptionally stable, psychically speaking.
The warp is not something you can take lightly.
No.
So I think I found this campaign's theme song at this point. It's obviously dumb ways to die. So many dumb ways to die. Dumb ways to die. So many dumb ways to die.
None of you are dead yet.
For the Eldar, at least. So far.
Well, I have to admit, I'm not super hopeful of surviving our trip into the Ghost Engine.
I think we'll be significantly better off casting around a shield, a living shield.
And that betters our chances, but...
I think that's the only way, literally the only way. Not betters our chance. It gives us a percentage from zero.
Technically, the Herald does have a weapon.
What, his brain or his arm?
He has one arm.
Is it a gun?
No, just the Dreadnought Claw.
Oh, okay.
I mean,
Dreadnought Chop!
I can't really see him punching from, a stationary position.
He doesn't really have a waist anymore. He can't wind up. But if he picks something up, he can crush it.
It's true.
Let's see, we should have saved the Farseer's gem for that. Hey, Harold, want to crush the alien?
He does.
But hey, now we can't tell him that we kept our word on that. They fucked with us, and then we destroyed him for that. We did say we would if they did.
Look how honorable we are.
What's the question? What was that device that the Farseer had? I mean, I suppose, Eldar can talk to other dead Eldar. As their brain is basically, a machine. When they're dead. But what was it?
More or less, you were basically just in a room where the Farseer's soul through her gem to the wraithbone of the ship was projecting a communication.
Oh, okay, so the lights were her making us go to her body.
Yes, well... to a place where she could directly communicate.
Right.
And also a room where she had mild control over Wraithguard.
Bitch. Did we not see any of them?
You did not. You would have seen them had you not immediately teleported out.
But searching the room for, stuff as well as the... Really?
They were sealed up.
Oh, well, in the wall?
Yes.
See, this is exactly the kind of shit that tipped Handsome Jack over the line.
Oh, Jack.
Having not actually played Borderlands 2, I'm only directly familiar with them from Tales of the Borderlands.
Oh, was it the Telltale game?
Yes, it is great.
I've only ever played Wolf Among Us.
Yeah, I heard it was good. Pre-sequel not too long ago.
I can't get into Borderlands.
I have some difficulty with it too, but the Telltale game remains a fucking Telltale game. It's good.
Not all Telltale games are good.
All of their Walking Dead and Onwards games have been good for me.
Game of Thrones one? I've seen videos of it. I've not played it. I've only seen videos of it, but it looks pretty...
It's the weakest of their new ones, but it's still very, very good. All about, narrative and choice, like all their games.
Aren't you guys stoked for the Minecraft Telltale game?
I have no idea how the fuck they're going to do that, but I know somehow they're going to.
Pam, that reminds me, I still need to finish Wolf Among Us.
It's amazing. I love it. I finished it twice.
I keep wanting to do like a group playthrough where like I get a bunch of my friends on like a voice chat or something like that, or like a video chat, and we all go through it together and make choices.
Yeah, I would be quite happy watching just other, like, my friends play it. I've already done it, just to see, like, their experience.
Yeah, I totally get what you mean. I would... Well, I definitely do actually suggest Tales from the Borderlands. It's good stuff.
Yeah.
If anyone wants to play actually Borderlands, I'll totally hop in a game with you.
Yeah, I can do that at some point.
Unlike the other... I suppose the Game of Thrones game does it, but kind of has to because it's Game of Thrones. But you alternate between two different protagonists in Tales from the Borderlands.
Oh.
Neither of which are the sort of crazy murder-hungry people who are usually people in Borderlands.
Isn't one of them like a... I don't know, like works for a company?
One of them is a Hyperion executive who worships Handsome Jack. Or a low-level Hyperion cubicle worker. And the other one is a con woman.
The other one is a what, sorry?
A con woman.
Oh, okay.
She has the gun that has a bullet.
A singular bullet?
A bullet. It's the extendy out of your sleeve kind. But, okay. Come next session, you will theoretically conclude a thing.
Theoretically?
Every time in every game I ever try to run, every time I think something's gonna end, somehow it drags on for 5 or 6 more sessions.
Okay, so it could end next session, but it could go on for longer.
Indeed.
Well, look on the bright side. The forest won't be there to interrupt us. That should move things right along.
That should also somewhat mitigate the number of demons and mutants that you encounter on the way there.
Let's hope so.
Well, on the one hand, demons could spawn just, you know, there spontaneously. Any of them that are there currently probably will be blasted into oblivion just like everything else in the forest.
Well, they shouldn't be in the forest.
It's where they live. It's their home. They do.
That was a bad choice. Yep.
Rest in peace, any tribal dudes who live in the forest.
Better than being eaten by demons.
Oh yeah, like, I totally don't care.
It is at least a quick, clean death.
Oh my god, I totally thought of the thing that I would try to do.
In what situation?
In the situation you guys are in. And it's a terrible idea, but I would love to try it.
Please go on.
You're already aware. Besides the Herald, you are already aware of how to suppress that damn warp field from the Ghost Engine. Go scoop up some Tyranids.
Oh, yeah. But I somehow don't think that would work entirely. Like, do dead Tyranids still radiate a presence?
Fuck no. But they weren't dead when you left them.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
So basically, we just sick a shit ton of Tyranids on that entire planet.
Sick the Tyranids on the demons. What could go wrong?
like, Tyranid-demon hybrids?
Tyranid can't be corrupted by the warp.
Can they not?
No.
I don't stand convinced.
Just like Orc can't be corrupted by the warp either.
Really? Is it just because they're the two machinations of, like, the Elder dudes? Like, the Elder gods?
The Old Ones. And, the old ones. Well, the Tyranid definitely aren't. The Tyranid are from this galaxy.
What do you mean,
there's
universe?
There's no way to negotiate with Tyranid, is there?
No. The Tyranid...
Didn't think so.
The Tyranid aren't sentient in a typical sense. They're, like, you know, super hive-mind sentient, but they're not, like, you know...
Are any of them capable of talking?
I don't think so. Maybe a Norn Queen. Maybe.
Well, I've not heard of that.
They're, like... They're tippy-top of the food chain. They're the ones who think up new Tyranid and just kind of gestate them.
Okay.